Hi there, Yogi, Virendra Yogi, with my wonderful friend, a smart, intelligent, very capable and affectionate. And once I tell you friend and affectionate, then let's go to the definition of friend. A friend in need is really a friend indeed. These pets you see, the white one, the black one in the background, and several others, they are moving all around me because I am in a place where there is some threat. But beloved friends, I tell you, these are external forces and friends. But I am the best friend of myself. You have to take full responsibility of your life. You were born, the parents were caring for you. They nourish you till you become adult. And after that, it's your life. Life is very precious. Life is real, life is earnest. And the grave is not his goal. Dust thou art, to dust returneth, was not spoken by the soul. Beloved friends, with its all, same drudgery and broken dreams, this world is still a beautiful place to live, but it needs wisdom and enlightenment. So you have to be very careful and responsible for your life. You have to be successful. What is success? Success is you think, you work very hard, you develop everything to support your life, food, shelter and clothing. The degree of quality may vary as per your thinking and as per your imagination and as per your acquisition. But even the bare necessity by minimum is also enough. Happiness sought by many but found by few. Happiness sought by many but found by few. Happiness is not wealth, power, position, but definitely it is a sound physical health, a positive mental attitude, a creative vision, a mind which is fully saturated with love, peace, joy, happiness, truth and justice. These are the ultimate source of happiness and these are the real blessings on earth. Beloved friends, I only sincerely request you, as said by one of the greatest and the wisest American, Ralph Waldo Emerson, think, use the creative and imaginative power of your brain. Never live like a cattle in the world's broad field of battle. In the bivouac of life, be not a dumb driven cattle, be a hero in this strife. Yes, be a hero, a valiant person, intelligent person. When I say intelligence, means you are thinking, you are using your brain. Today the world is so beautiful, it is because of the visionary leaders. Because more gold has been mined from the brain than it has been dug from the earth, you see. Because we could be living just like cattle, animals, but the intelligence and the brain power of the man give us clothes. Otherwise we could be living like my pet, you see. You see, nothing is here. Even the color I have given it, otherwise it can be naked. It is our intelligence, thinking how to cover our body, save us from heat, cold and all circumstances which cannot be surviving. Beloved friends, it's the brain, it is intelligence. And once we have got clothing, we search for food, we search for water. Even water is not everywhere. Water is only available near fountains, rivers. But now the whole earth is carpeted by civilization, the towns, cities and villages. We learn the art of drilling bores, wells, and we develop water everywhere else. And man's intelligence is not confined to earth itself. As Stephen Hawking said, we are soon going to colonize the moon and the Mars. Everywhere we will create the congenial circumstances where human civilization can live. It is not the power of the body, remember it. It is definitely the power of the mind. Otherwise, why dinosaurs could be extinguished from the earth? They have the mighty power, but they don't have the intelligence and the power of brain. But what to talk of the people who are human beings, blessed with 100 billion cells of their neurons, which can really make them intelligent like Einstein, Newton and Stephen Hawking and all other greats, but they never use that power of the brain. That's why Ralph Waldo Emerson said, what is the most difficult thing on earth? To think. That's why I suggest you, and I want to stimulate your intelligence to the perception and discovery of truth, that you yourself are maker of yourself by virtue of the thought you choose and encourage. And your strength is your mind. Your mind is just like the land, the soil. Whatever seed of thought you are planting in your mind, that is growing one day and giving you the fruits. Be very careful. You can get everything what you think, but think always good, positive. For myself, I always think health, wealth, peace, prosperity, truth and justice, and love and affection, joy, happiness, serenity. I never allow anybody to be in my vicinity who is a man with negative mental attitude, because they are worse than cobras. Their venomous thoughts of evils can ruin your life and you become miserable. So take hold of yourself. Take the full responsibility of your life. Must have a definite goal in your life. It must be a passion for you, a burning desire for you, a consuming obsession of your life, because you know where you are going, and you will become what you are dreaming, desiring, aspiring, persevering and persisting with a mighty willpower. You have the ability, you have the capability. Develop tremendous self-belief, self-confidence, self-reliance. Believe in yourself, and your eye is the real indication of your greatness. As Ralph Waldo Emerson said, every person carries in his eyes the exact indication of his rank. So develop the pride full with confidence, courage, conviction, belief, faith, determination, passion. You are a strong-headed. You are a strong-headed. Must be resolutely willed and steadfastly hold your inner conviction that you are not cattle. You are brave. You are great. You are blessed with body, brain, mind, talents and faculties. Now, as per your inclination and as per your love, nourish that faculties of your brain where you can become anything and everything else. There are different callings and areas. You can be an author, you can be a poet, you can be a sculptor, you can be a musician, you can be an actor, you can be a thinker, you can be a philosopher. Every person has contributed significantly. That's why the world is so beautiful. Never deny the contribution of the thinkers and philosophers. Buddha was one of the great thinkers. Jesus, a lot of other people were thinkers. They did not give material things to you, but they gave you really thought how to live happily on earth. I am one such thinker. Don't ask me what hell you are talking always. I am talking sense, I am making you responsible. And you are far, far better than me. But are you thinking? Have you taken full possession of your mind? And you are controlling and directing towards some noble thoughts? You are thinking to be an industrialist? You are thinking to be a great political leader like Abraham Lincoln? But I am thinking. I want to be Buddha. I do not know, I have no enlightenment, but I will learn what he taught and I will tell you. I will remind you. I will let you know that you are very short-lived on earth. As said by Marcus Aurelius, your life is what your thoughts are making to you. And always think what Steve Jobs thought. You can pass away any time. So stay hungry and stay foolish. And as Steve Jobs did, stand before mirror every early in the morning and ask yourself, my life, I, myself, what I shall be doing today, what I have planned to do if it were the last day of my life. Live every day as it is the last day of your life. That is reminding you the transitory and short-lived nature of life. It also inspire you to budget your time, money, energy. Never waste it. Commit yourself. Dedicate yourself. Be a very significant, important person. What we call VIP, very important person. Be a lovable person. Be a person with pleasing personality and positive mental attitude. Do some creativity. Do some wonderful things. And believe me, you will become what you think about. We are what we think. All that we are arises with our thought. With our thought, we make our world. Remember what one of the greatest sculptors said, the painter from Rome. It is not strange that we dream too big, desire so high, plan so great and we failed. It is misery and pity that we dream very small, we desire little, and we immediately accomplish that task. Mind is having creative power, which is limitless, astounding power beyond your imagination. Whatever the mind can conceive and believe, the mind can achieve for you. Because you have belief, you must have courage, you must have creative vision, imagination, and demand from your life, demand from your mind, and you will be what you will to be. Never mind failures, let failure find its false content in the poor world, environment, but its spirit scorns it and is free. It masters times, it conquers space, it calls the boastful, takes a chance, and it beats the tyrant circumstance and fills with servant place. The human will that forces on sin, the human will that forces on sin, the offspring of a deathless soul, can hew away to any goal. The walls of granite intervene. Don't be afraid of adversity, misfortune. Everything will come to your way, but they always go away defeated because you don't believe in defeat. You believe in victory, 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 victory at all costs. You are ready to stake your existence for the fulfillment of your dream. Because you believe, win or perish, do or die, victory or death. You want to win.